ಪತಿಂ ಸುರಗುರುಂ ವಂದೇ ಜಗತ್ಕಾರಣಂ ವಂದೇ ಪನ್ನಗಭೂಷಣಂ ಶಶಿಧರಂ ವಂದೇ ಪಶೂನಾಂ ಪತಿಂ ವಂದೇ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಶಶಾಂಕ ವನ್ನಿನಯನಂ ವಂದೇ ಮುಕುಂದ ಪ್ರಿಯಂ ವಂದೇ ಭಕ್ತಜನ ಆಶ್ರಯಂ ಚ ವರದಂ ವಂದೇ ಭಕ್ತಜನ ಆಶ್ರಯಂ ಚ ವರದಂ ವಂದೇ ಶಿವಂ ಶಂಕರಂ. ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಎಜುಕೇಶನ್ ಫಾಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಐ ಡೂ ಟೂ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ಸೇಸ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ವಿವೇಕಾನಂದ. What are those two things which he wants to do? Number one, instill an ideal, goal fixation. Two, teach concentration, learn how to concentrate. If these two things are done, life has fulfillment. Education has its accomplishment and success. People will be peaceful and prosperous. Raja Yoga consists of two things. Number one, fix the goal. Number two, put in the concentrated effort to realize the goal. If these two things are done, it is in the modern sense and in the eternal sense real Raja Yoga. The entire Bhagavad Gita speaks of strength. It speaks of courage. It speaks of conviction. It speaks of goal fixation. It speaks of concentration. Arjun in the first chapter has arrived at the battlefield with a fixed goal. What is that fixed goal for Arjun? To kill the enemy, to remove the impediments, to establish in Hastinapur the righteous kingdom, to make Yudhishthir the king of Hastinapur. That's the goal fixed by Arjuna. And he has arrived on the battlefield. He has lost the concentration to realize the goal. When his mind is confused, when it has lost concentration, he lost the goal also. And therefore he tells Krishna, my dear Krishna, nakanche vijayam Krishna. Earlier the goal is kanche rajyam, I want kingdom. Nakanche vijayam Krishna, I don't want victory. Earlier he wants the kingdom. He wants the success. He wants to be the boss. He wants to be the supreme, highest, greatest, most ambitious. After seeing the enemies, after seeing his cousins, after seeing the battlefield, there is a strange weakness that has crept into his heart. And he says, goal is changed. Earlier the goal is to become king, to be victorious. Now the goal has changed. Na kanche, I don't desire. Na means no, kanche means desire. Na kanche, vijayam, victory. Krishna, I don't want victory. I don't want kingdom. What do you want? I want to go to the woods, sit under the green wood trees shade, close my nostrils, meditate on Brahman. And Krishna said, you fellow, you don't have concentration to maintain your goal now. Do you mean to say you will have the concentration when you meditate? You are weak. You are unable to be firm. You are unable to be strong. Kshudram hridaya durbalyam tyaktvottishta parantapa. Parantapa is Arjuna. Uttishta, get up, man. Kshudram, meanest, weakest, worst. Hridaya durbalyam. Your heart is weak. Your mind is weak. Your decision is not strong. You are not determined. You don't have the concentration. You don't have the concerted effort. This is a psychic weakness. Now, two things. First is goal fixation. The second is the effort to be put in for the realization of the goal. Arjuna has lost both. And therefore, the entire Bhagavad Gita is to make man fix the goal and put in the effort to realize the goal. We have people. What is the goal? When I see an excellent actor on the stage, he should become a good actor. People should be glad. I must be another Kamala Hassan. I must be another Amitabh Bachchan. Acting is wonderful. All over the world will be there. Next day, you find Jesus or Bhagavad Krishna or S.P. Balasubramanian with thousands and thousands of people listening. I must become a very good singer. You forgot becoming an actor. Next day, you find the chief of the army staff being greeted, saluted by everybody. I must become the chief of the army staff. After that, you will find another wonderful orator. I must speak like him. And another day, you find some other person. Goal is drifting. Goal is changing. Fix the goal. We are weak. That's what Arjuna says. Chanchalam himana Krishna. My dear Krishna, my mind manaha chanchalam. It's oscillating. It's wavering, it's wandering, it's moving, it is unable to fix the goal. When I look at a beautiful girl, she is wonderful, I shall marry her. And next day, another girl, oh, this girl is much more. And that girl in England, wonderful. Love is not love, which alters when it alteration finds. Love is firm. Love is strong. Love is with courage. Love is with strength. Love is one, sacred, pure, pious, determined. Right from the lowest to the highest, in any walk of life, in any field of study, goal fixation is essential. And Krishna's goal has changed. Therefore, entire Raja Yoga speaks of two things. One is goal fixation and the other is this. For both, what is it that should be under control? Mind. If the mind is under control, goal can be fixed. If the mind is under control, concentration can be attained. Without concentration, we cannot put in the effort. Without the concentrated effort, goal cannot be realized. Goal is wavering, concentration is wavering. And therefore, Krishna says, my dear Arjun, true, asamsayam mahabaho, doubtless. Mahabaho, you are Arjun, you have strength, wonderful, strong muscles of iron and nerves of steel. You have a robust body, strong personality, majestic, mighty, attractive, bewitching, enticing, wonderful personality you have. But what is the use? You are weak. Weak at heart. Asamsayam mahabaho. Mahabaho is praising the man. Mano durnigraham. Mind is hard to control. There is no doubt about it. Vayoriva sudushkaram. It's very difficult, just as we cannot hold the air in our fist. It is very difficult to maintain the mind firm. Asamseyo. Then what is the way out? I must fix the goal. I must learn to be concentrated. What is the way out? Abhyasena tu kaunteya. Practice. What practice? I give you some examples, Mr. Arjun. Try to take the examples and I will give you practical tips for Abhyasa. You can follow them. Number one, in Ramakrishna Math, a contemporary of Swami Vivekananda, there was a Swami called Turiyananda. He was a man of excellent control over the body, mind, intellect, equipment. One day, a brahmachari came, or a college student came to become a brahmachari. He fell at the feet of Turiyanand Swami. Swamiji, yes, I want to become a sannyasi in Ramakrishna Math. Prior to that, I would like to become a brahmachari. Please take me. Then Swami Turiyanand sir said, good. Open your mouth. Yes, sir. Stretch your tongue. Yes, sir. He brought a little sugar, Turiyanand Swami. I shall put this sugar on your tongue. The sugar should not become melted. Just as the sugar remains the same on a piece of paper, if the sugar on your tongue does not become liquid, you are fit to become a brahmachari. Do you have control over your tongue? You have no control over your tongue. You want to speak, 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 tongue-ish. And you don't have control over tongue. You want to eat, 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 eat. The moment Rasgulla is described, white, round, soft, sweet, air hostess, bringing the plate, giving Rasgulla, there is water. You are unfit. Swami Turiyananda says, control your tongue. Don't look at that side, don't look. We follow. Two, there is a total control over the body. Trigunatheeta was another gentleman, a contemporary of Swami Vivekananda. There were about 16 people in the mat, direct disciples of Sri Ramakrishna. One day, host invited them all. Last minute, all the people had to go somewhere. And Swami Vivekananda told that host, I am sorry, we have to go to some other place. Then the host said, sir, I have prepared food for nearly 25 people. What do I do with the food? Don't worry, I am sending you one gentleman, Trigunatheetananda. What for, sir? He will eat the entire food. Trigunatheeta came. The food was brought. He asked for more. 25 people's food he ate. Total control over the body, either to expand or to contract immunity. And he was capable of remaining without food for even 20 days, 30 days at a stretch. Sir, these are all stories. In our ashram, in our prashanti, the Raja Yoga Pitha was occupied by a particular gentleman. We call him Protoplasm Swami. His photograph is here. Every year he comes here. He is from Nellore. And that Swami is 88 years. Morning 200 ml milk. Evening 200 ml milk. That's all. You cannot walk with him. Strong, sturdy, active, brisk, dynamic. Body should listen to you. Mind should listen to you. All the three examples. Abhyasena tu kaunteya. Practice, man. Don't take coffee. Don't take tea. Take only 100 ml of milk or 100 grams of food. There is a measurement. You have to practice it. And day to day in our life, what is the practice? Sit erect. Samam kaya shiro grivam. If we begin to practice sitting erect, we get confidence. While walking, brisk walk, straight walk, you get confidence. When talking to somebody, look straight into the eyes, not angrily. Don't shy away. Then you will get confidence. Mastery over the mind, control over the senses, decision-making capacity, determination, firmness, courage, conviction, confidence. These are the elements of Rajayoga. In the public sector and in the private sector, I might have conducted hundreds of interviews so far. In the interview, what we do is, we look at your eyes. It is in the eye a person's confidence can be seen. A person's strength can be seen, conviction can be seen. When Swami Vivekananda was walking in Chicago, people were astounded to see his eyes oozing confidence. And that confidence is Rajayoga. In the king, you should have mastery. In the king, you should find royalty. In the king, you should find dynamism. In the king, you should find the commanding capacity. In the king, you should find that goal fixation. And all those elements are necessary for the officers. It's a leadership quality. To be successful in life, we must have these two elements, goal fixation and the concentration. The entire Rajayoga for the student community and for any person consists of two things, fixed goal and the concentrated effort put together is confidence. Strength. All the eight volumes of Swami Vivekananda, if you squeeze, only one word will come, and that is confidence. Strength. May we all, by the grace of God Almighty, Lord Krishna, who is the very embodiment of confidence and strength, develop that Rajayoga of confidence, mastery over everything. Let us meditate on that wonderful, mighty personality, Lord Krishna, of strength and confidence, so that we can imbibe the spirit of Rajayoga.